Welcome everyone, I'm Jillian.
My name is Leon.
We are EVHS Kababayan Club and we are proud to present Koponan, our Filipino showcase.
Our show's theme is inspired by the different regions of the Philippines and how we're all uniquely connected together. Tonight we'll be viewing all the hard work that our performers have been putting in for the past few months. But before we get started, we would like to start with the national anthem sung by our very own members of Kababayan, because you know, we all love to sing.
Bayang mag-iliw, perlas ng sinanganan, alam ng puso, sa titibo'y buhay. Lupang hinirang, tuyan ka na magiting, sa manlulupig, di ka pa sisihir, sa daga at bundok, sa simoy at sa lagi mong bukhaw. Magilag ang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kisap ng watawa mo'y tagumpay na naniling. Ang bituin na araw niya ka lang pa may di magbibiling. Lupa ng araw ng buwan, hati pagsita, buhay langit sa pilin mo. Aming ligaya na pag may mga api, ang mamatay lang dahil sa'yo.
Now, for our first act of the show, we have Itik-Itik, which directly translates to Duck Duck. Here we're traveling all the way to the bottom of the Philippines where the Mindanao region is located.
This dance originates from the province of Surigao and is a dance that imitates the movement of a duck.
Introducing our Kaba women, it's Itik-Itik!
Amazing.
Next up, coming all the way from Mrs. Marcia's houses, we have Layla. Layla is a loving girl who enjoys listening to lots of Olivia Rodrigo.
She also likes to sing. Did she mention that?
Car rides to Malibu, strawberry ice cream. One spoon for two and trading jackets. Laughing about how small it looks on you. Watching reruns of Glee, being annoying. Singing in harmony, I bet she's bragging. to all our friends saying you're so unique. So when you're gonna tell her that we did that too, she thinks it's special, but it's all reused. That was our place, I found it first, I made the jokes you tell to her when she's with you. Do you get deja vu when she's with you? Do you get deja vu? Do you get deja vu? Do you call her? Almost say my name, 'cause let's be honest, we kinda do sound the same. Another actress, I hate to think that I was just your type. I bet you she knows Billy Joel, 'cause you played her uptown girl, you're singing it together now. I bet you even tell her how you love her in between the chorus and the verse.
I love you.
So when you gonna tell her that we did that too, she thinks it's special, but it's all reused. That was the show we talked about, played you the song she's singing now when she's with you. Do you get deja vu when she's with you? Do you get deja vu? Oh. Do you get deja vu? Oh. Strawberry ice cream in Malibu. Don't act like we didn't do that crap too. You're trading jackets like we used to do.
Yeah, everything is all reused.
Play her piano, but she doesn't know that I was the one who taught you Billy Joel. A different girl now, but there's nothing new.
I know you get deja vu.
Wasn't that amazing?
I thought that was very amazing.
Well, thank you to all the acts thus far, but I think it's time for a little commercial break. This commercial break is brought to you by one of Kaba's very own personal fans called All Jeremy No Fashion. Enjoy!
After a long day of doing nothing, do you ever try to cook something through your microwave, but it's just not working? Do you ever look in the mirror and wonder how you can unlock your inner light skin? Maybe it's by shaving your eyebrows. Even your dog is depressed. Well, look no further than the Vicks VapoRub. Just apply the ointment before you go to sleep, blow your orifices, and let it do its magic, sis. Your dreams of waking up as a brand new Kelly Oubre Jr. can finally come true. Just look how happy one of our customers is. Now go out there and apply that Vicks VapoRub all over that sexy jawline of yours. Trust me, you won't regret it.
Ruff, 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 ruff.
But wait, don't wait, because if you buy the Vicks VapoRub right now for the low price of $5.99, we'll include another one for free. This product is laced with psilocybin, tetrahydrocannabis, and lysergic acid thiamide. Side effects may or may not include dizziness, drowsiness, seizures, blood clots, constipation, stomach aches, 2 fat cakes, blackouts, gonorrhea, student debt, rent, mortgage, or HIV. 100% of you should experience death, a light headache, and your mom. If you experience any of the listed side effects, please go to your local Asian medicine store that sells ginger, as a regular doctor can help you. High and drunk, call the HD Vision. You must sign a contract in order to buy this product. We are liable for any damage done to your home, and please do not contact a lawyer. Batteries not included.
Great job, All Jeremy No Passion. We'll definitely think about using Vicks VapoRub for everything and anything.
Now let's take a trip to the town of Binan in the region of Luzon, where the dance of our next act originates from. Presenting Maglaladik, choreographed by Alex Prime Zumel.
Paso!
Polynesian is next. Tonight, they'll be dancing a piece choreographed by their very own officers. Let's give it up for Polynesian.
You see this one type of woman that I love. She gotta be from heaven, angel sent from up above. She knows what she wants, she ain't afraid to get it. And when she playing shy, she's still confident to fit it. See, I'm the type of dude who can seem a little picky. And I'm from a small town south of Oakland City. If you that kind of lady, then don't try to fight it. Cause I wanna talk to you, come and sit beside me.
If you want me in the summer,
we'll hit the beach if you love it. Swim, we'll just chill if you wanna.
If you want me in the fall,
we'll let the gentle winds blow. Wait for the sunset, takes a toll.
In the springtime,
we'll take a walk for an hour. Let my garden bloom while I pick your favorite flower.
Or in the winter,
hold hands if you want. Keep your body close till the temperature is warm.
Yeah, you need to know, I wanna be with you all year long. I just wanna be with you. Tell me, can I be with you? Your smile's what gets me through my day. You chase my
even on cloudy days.
Don't answer that. Next up, our current and future officers are battling out to see who can make the best lumpia.
Who won?
Let's find out.
Hey guys, so we're here at Manila Market. We're gonna make some lumpia today. Now we're gonna get some oil. Jillian!
We gotta get this vegetable oil.
Vegetable oil, because vegetables. Okay, here we go. Where's the next, Alex?
Produce.
Take us on this adventure.
Yeah, we're gonna get one more cabbage.
This is what we have so far. Bunch of this stuff. So how do you find the perfect cabbage?
It has to be big and it has to not be deadly. This one's good? This one's good?
Yep.
Okay, what's your favorite vegetable, Francesca?
Me?
Yeah, behind the camera energy, what's your favorite vegetable?
I like bok choy.
That's a good one.
Yep.
You said they turned right?
I think so. Let's check left. Oh yay!
Magic flakes.
What's that? What's that?
I got something big.
Anything else, team?
No.
Alright, then we'll see you at the house.
Town with chestnuts.
None of that.
Hi, I'm Alex. I have no experience in cooking, but I've seen a lot of cooking shows.
I'm full Filipino, so my ancestors must have done this before. Thank you. Your turn,
what do you
Okay.
I'm not Filipino, so let's go.
Something before we start.
Hey, we're gonna win. We're going.
Because of this. You wanna say something before we win? Or before?
No,
yeah.
No.
Yeah,
hey,
yeah.
Before we win. Yeah, before we win.
I mean,
So first up, I'm gonna cut off this little dead part right here, or this little booty part.
Talk to me. Yeah, yeah. Like you want to make lumpia.
Yeah, I want to.
That's busting. Skin is busting.
Okay. Wait, hold it.
And what better way to do that than hand it over to our next fan. MS Jesus, you're up.
Has this ever happened to you?
Whoa! I dropped all my pistachios. Wait, I have just the thing.
Reach for the Walis. The Walis is the best cleaning tool out there. It cleans dirt, spills, and food better than any product you can think of. Plus, it's super cheap and easy to use. Wasn't that so easy?
Wow, that was so easy.
Still not convinced? Let's hear from some of our customers.
This is the greatest purchase I've ever made.
Wow, I don't know how I could live without it. I mean, it's good, but my dog always eats.
So the next time this happens to you.
But Olivia Rodrigo's album comes out, so.
Make sure you get the Walis.
Thank you, MS Jesus. As Kababayan, we love to support our fellow AAPI clubs. So the second club that we'll be performing tonight is Taiko. So let's give it up for Taiko.
Go Taiko! Thank you.
Thank you, Tycho. Well, now you know her as Francesca, but we know her as Angie, Kacheschus, Chestnut, and most recently added, Jessica. Fran is a freshman and one of the fastest runners out there.
She can also sing, but don't take my word for it. Here's Francesca singing tonight.
Elementary pa lang, napapansin na nila mga gawi kong parang hindi pambabae. Kasi imbis na Chinese garter, laruan ko ay text sa Jolens. Tapos kajamming ko lagi noon mga signal laki sa amin. Nung ako'y mag high school ay napabarkada sa mga bay. Cuties na babae na ang hanap din ay babae. Sa halip na makeup kit, pit-pit ko ay gitara. Tapos parman ko lagi ay long sleeves na t-shirt at faded na lonta. Pero nung nakilala kita, nagbang bigla ang aking timpla. Natutuwa ko na magparabanda at mag-ayat ng kilay. Please once a month, hindi ko alam kung ano meron ka na sa akin. Ay nagpalambot ng bigla, sinong baga ka lang lalaki pa lang. Bibiyak sa tulad kong tigreng gala. Kahit ako'y titibo-tibo, puso ko ay titibok-tibok pa rin sa'yo. Isang halik mo lamang at ako ay tinatablan. At ang aking pagkababae ay nabubuhayan. Na parabang bulaklak na namumukatkat. Dahil alago mo sa dilig at katamtamang sikat ng araw-araw mong pag-ibig sa'king buhay nagpapasarap. College ay saka ko lamang binigay ang matamis na oo. Sampung buwan mong trinabaho sa halip na tsokolate at tipikal na mga diskarte. Nabihag mo ko sa mga tulad sa mga katamang pabebe. Kaya nga nung makilala kita, alam mo na agad na mayroong himala. Natutuwa kong mata kong nga na parlas ang pagsuot ng bastidang pula. Pero di mo naman inasam na ako'y magwang tuluyan para patunang walang matigas na tinapay sa mani. Nakapin ang iyong pagmamahal. Kahit ako'y titibok-tibok, puso ko ay titibok-tibok pa rin sa'yo. Isang halik mo lamang at ako ay tinatablan. At ang aking pagkababae ay nabubuhayan. Na parabang bulaklak na namumukadkad. Dahil alaga mo sa dilig at katamtamang sikat ng araw-araw mong pag-ibig sa'king buhay nagpapasarap.
Francesca, your voice is quite amazing. And next up, we have our very own Kate DeMolanta with a TED Talk about social inequality. Go ahead, Kate.
Hi, my name is Kate DeMolanta, and I am this year's Kababayan president. I identify as a second-generation Filipino-American, and I am the daughter of two parents of the 1.5 generation. What does 1.5 gen mean? Well, my parents were babies when they moved here to the US, which means they have little to no memories of living in the Philippines. They were forced to assimilate to American culture in order to achieve the American dream of my grandparents. But in turn, the connection I have to my own roots is far from where I want them to be. But as I grow older, I become more interested in these topics. Growing up, my public schooling never properly taught me about my roots. In history textbooks, Filipinos were rarely mentioned. What they failed to teach me, and what I had to learn myself, was how racial hierarchy is also present in the Philippines. I'm here to talk to you about how learning our roots can help us connect our experiences to what is currently going on in our native country, and in turn, gain a better global perspective. But before I go into more depth, I would like to explain what the Filipino government is composed of. The Philippines has an oligarchical government. Instead of having a democracy where many people are running the country, or a monarchy, just one person, we are left with a very small few who have power. I quote, "Elections are controlled by a small number of families who are in business of serving themselves rather than the country's over 1 million people." Keep this quote in mind as we discuss three specific topics: colorism, education, and poverty. First, colorism is seen through misrepresentation in the Filipino media. Celebrities, news broadcasters, and advertisements usually feature and encourage pale complexions to those with naturally darker skin. The theory of racial hierarchy in the Philippines tells us that from the 16th century, Spanish colonizers, quote, associated dark-skinned Filipinos with poor laborers, while those with lighter skin, being mixed-race Filipinos, were in the upper class. Other than Spain, the Philippines was also conquered by the US and Japan at certain points, who, coincidentally, but not really, are all of inherently fair complexion. The constant state of warfare and colonialism in the Philippines has almost indefinitely changed the ideas behind our own genetics. Personally, when I thought about this idea, I felt very conflicted with myself because I feel happy when I see another fellow Filipino, as we are the minority in America. But until now, I never once believed that Filipinos could be colorist to their own kind. But I want to come back to this thought later. Next, the lack of education is also a huge issue. In order to reach a specific status in the Philippines, one must be given enough resources for not only themselves, but their entire family. Those who are impoverished are not able to obtain that quality education because of expenses, thus widening the gap of educated and uneducated. And this brings me to my final point. Relative poverty is an outcome of these and many other problems in the Philippines. Relative poverty means that there is a, quote, line of insufficient goods and services through the support of money and resources, through the support of the government. With the high levels of social inequality already, those with this disadvantage are often paid less because of the lack of education, and in turn are not able to provide themselves for the most basic necessities. Other reasons for poverty include the high demand but lack of jobs due to the Philippines' increasingly high population. Without programs proposed and carried out successfully by the government, the Philippines will only suffer more with unemployment and poverty. But going back to my point about noticing the differences in my behavior towards Filipinos against natives thinking about their own kind. Here in the US, we see colorism and lack of education and poverty almost every day. It's sort of a common topic that we talk about comfortably. But what I found is that because of the bubble that I live in Evergreen, in San Jose, and even in America, sometimes I overlook these ideas and how they could actually relate to our own native countries. Just because it's happening here in the US doesn't necessarily mean it's not happening anywhere else. But this is not a coincidence. Centuries and centuries of Eurocentric ideology and racism and slavery have shaped our unconscious biases. So it's not so much that people are bad, but more that the people who have influenced us for generations have made an impact that turns us against each other. What is the solution to all this, you might ask? Well, for starters, I believe in the quality education of young students, and that is the main reason why I wanted to talk about this specific truth. If we are adamant about equity in our own communities, we must come to realize the connections we have with each other through the history of our own people to better recognize these issues and unite together in order to stop them. I want to end off with a quote from Dr. Soledad Muesco Munaay. She says, "Remember your roots, but expand your worldview." Thank you.
Thank you, Kate, for the hard work that you put into that TED Talk. I definitely learned something new there. How about you?
Well, I sure did. But man, oh man, I think it's time for a break with some snacks like shrimp chips, sweet corn, or maybe even sky flakes.
I had to work in the US to support my anaks. It's been hard couple years, and miss na miss ko na sila. I hope to see them soon and hope they are doing well. I sent you a balikbayan box with 6 sky flakes, one for an important memory I missed. Time you sing with a band. One for your first dance recital. One for your first day of kindergarten. One for your first time riding a bike. And one for your elementary school promotion. You might wonder why there are only 5 sky flakes in the box. Go to the backyard to get the 6th one.
Thank you for the commercial. It's time for our final club of the night.
We love all of the diverse clubs at EV that highlight the many different forms of art and performance in the world. So as our last club of the night, give it up for jazz. Woo! Woo! Thank you.
John. That was amazing. Really love that. Now it's time for the act that we've all been waiting for.
Tinikling originated in the islands of Leyte in the Visayas region during the Spanish colonial era and is one of the most widely known Filipino cultural dances.
Our final cultural dance for the night, Koponan brings you Tinikling, choreographed by Kate DeVolanta. Thank you, dancers. That was amazing. We love representing and showing off Tinikling.
So, remember all those amazing costumes that you saw during our performances tonight? Well, let's take a closer look at them.
That I love. She gotta be from heaven, angel sent from up above.
Hey guys, Kate here. From being Kababayan for all 4 years, I've learned many things. And although one of those things was not Tagalog, I think I did pretty good with this one. So I hope you guys enjoy. This is Tila Tala by Siddhartha.
Kapag nahulog ng taloy ang alaking damdamin, nariyan ka ba para ako'y saluhin? Mukhang malabo, mukhang sa panaginip ko lamang posible to. Bakit ganito? Sa lahat ng tao, ikaw pa sino ba naman ako para piliin mo? Kalangitan kaakit-akit subalit ako'y hanggang tinging lang kahit anong pilit na'y kaya butin hindi ka kailanmang magiging para sa akin kahit itanong pili hindi ka papasa akin. Malabo, malabong, malabo. Malabo, malabong, malabo. Malabo, malabo, malabong. Ako ang pipiilin mo. Malabo, malabong, malabo. Malabo, malabong, malabo. Malabo, malabong, malabo. Piliin mo ang tulot ko. Tila talas sa kalangitan kaakit-akit subalit ako'y hanggang tinging lang kahit anong pilit na'y kaya butin hindi ka kailanmang magiging para sa kahit itanong pili di ka mapapasa akin.
Hello to my audings. I just wanted to say I appreciate every single one of you for being committed to this club, for participating, for always being there when I need it or anyone else in Kaba needs it. Without you, Kaba wouldn't be here, and without you, the show wouldn't be here. So again, I just wanted to say thank you so much for being a part of this family. I hope that you guys can continue to do stuff like this to empower each other and to just make the most out of high school, even if you have tough situations. This year was definitely really hard for us as a club, but we powered through it. And honestly, I wasn't that surprised because I know how incredibly strong and incredibly talented and incredibly amazing each and every one of you are. So with that being said, to Alex, I'm really proud of you. I'm really excited for what you have in store for our club. And I love you. So thank you for watching. Bye.
Oh, thank you, Kate. That was really emotional and we truly loved the performance. Now for our final act of the night, we have Kababayan. And Kababayan will always be known as a culture club, but there's one thing we also love doing.
We love to dabble in other forms of dance that revolve around hip-hop and R&B music. So for the final act of the night, Kababayan presents a performance choreographed by Alex Nguyen, Kate DeMolanta, along with Leon Tran. Give it up for them! Woo!
Don't ever play with me. I'm the hip-hop queen. You dirty bum. Drinks on them.
Woke up, the price of woke up. I just hit them with the low cut, then call my folks up. Somebody about to get poked up, go call a tow truck. All that talking out your neck might just get your throat cut. This a Mack truck, not a black truck. When we move, tell them back up. Click, click, clack, duck. Hella bands, pull up stashed up. Super facts up. Will you uh-oh, get your arrows up. Yikes, I play tag and you it for life. Yikes, You a clown, you do it for likes. Yikes, yes it's tight, but it doesn't bite. Rip it right, he be like, I keep two dimes, yeah. Walk up to a bat, be like, I think you fine, yeah. I don't play with get thee behind, yeah. About to give up a margarita with two limes, yeah. Been the same, ain't she changed? This ain't nothing new. That pretty frame, diamond chain, what the f*** to do? Yo, clear the way, it's some bad bitches coming through. I give two F's like the letters that are on my shoe.
All this attention, so baby,
got no mouth for money bag talk. It's quiet, ain't no back talk. Quiet, ain't no back talk.
Turn up a night, we want to tell a story that we tell every practice, and as Kababayan, we hold it close to our club and culture. It's called Isang Bagsak. It's a story that was told by four farm workers at every meeting called Dolores Huerta, Cesar Chavez, Larry Itleon, and Philip Veracruz. These four farm workers came together to create the United Farm Workers Association to fight for what they wanted, which was a minimum wage. And they met in secrecy and rioted and met together. And at the end of every meeting, they would do, like I said, what is called an Isang Bagsak, which means one down. But here at EV, we translate it to one family, one fall, because if one of us falls, we all fall. And if one of us rises, we all rise. And how we do Isang Bagsak is all girls form kind of a circle, and one girl in the center claps to the sound of her heartbeat as everyone else around her follows. And the guys on the outside, or one guy on the outside starts to say Bog, as a girl on the other say Isang. Sorry, Isang, then Bog. And then all together, we all stomp and say Sak together. And that's the story.
Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's show. We really appreciate every one of you, especially to all the performers and the people who worked on the show.
And special thanks to Mr. De Rosario, our co-advisor who has helped to schedule and organize all this stuff to make this event possible. Thank you guys.
See ya.
Bye. Thank you for watching. Woo!